Neighbourhood Pole Painter.
And hi, I'm Emily from the Paint Box School of Art, and we are in Fernwood Square, Victoria, BC, Canada, and we are showing you guys how to paint a telephone pole.
NRG pole painting day. Step one, find yourself a pole. This is a beauty. It's been painted. It was a really nice pole at first, and then it's got a little tagged. So now we're going to clean it up, and we're going to just sort of take off all the thumbtacks, maybe any sort of little pieces of paper. It's in pretty good shape, this pole. Oh, there's another tack up here. So the next thing we're going to do is protect our environment by putting on some drop cloths or newspapers and making sure that's all taped down, and some great wet paint signs so that while this is drying and people are walking by, that they're aware that it's wet and it doesn't get on people's clothes. Next step is to tape the top of your pole so that you create nice clean line, and you know where you're stopping. This one's really tall. Alright, there we go. Next step will be to prime the pole. Looks good. Looks great. So I'll just clean up my area. So I'll have to wait for this to dry for a couple of hours, and then it'll be ready to go. Okay, so we primed the pole yesterday.
Yeah, looks nice and dry now.
So if your stencil works both ways, you can turn it around. Just don't flip it on the other side of the paper until this side's dry. So we've changed colors. We didn't have a lot of yellow, so we're going to use some orange. But we're using our yellow sponges because yellow and orange mix nicely. So it's all good. So areas where you don't cut all the way through, otherwise your stencil will kind of fall apart and it won't stay together. But once you finish painting your stencil, you want to paint over the bridges. Thank you.
gonna make a valiant effort.
I think we'll go with the small sponge.
Yeah, we're gonna use a smaller sponge.
Yeah.